goes up to the high side, and that's where he wants to run. Our two national half mile winners in this one, number 11, Scotty Parker, and number 8, Steve Eklund. Number 53, Tim Mertens, is running third. That will be the bump spot, and young Billy Herndon, number 19 from Texas, is running fourth. The rookie, number 3Z, Robin Land, is fifth. 1, 2, and 3. Parker starting to widen out at the south end very early in this event. The highest groove runner here at Ascot. And there's a rider with mechanical trouble dropping out, coming out of turn two, no problem. It's Scotty Parker, Steve Eklund, and number 53, Mertens. All Harley Davidson in the opening heat, except now the rookie, number 85, Q, running in the number 6 position. The last remaining member of the Harley-Davidson racing team that started the 1984 season. And now Mertens, Tim Mertens, number 53, pushing Steve Eklund for second place and a possible front row start. He's tightening it up. Parker's teammate Randy Goss out with a broken leg, and Jay Springsteen missing yet another race for that stomach ailment. So we're at Parker, and he's joined tonight by Mickey Fay. The factory Harley of Scotty Parker leading three privateer Harley and one privateer Honda. These are the first five. Here on lap 7. 7 laps completed for Parker, 3 to go. Eklund now going to try and hold on for second. A rookie running fourth in Robert Land from Porterville. A rookie is running fifth in Dan Bennett from Oregon. Two rookies in the top 5 of this opening 10 lap heat. Parker, Eklund, Tim Mertens, Robert Land, and Dan Bennett. One, two, and three. We'll transfer. The white flag is out. Parker up there now, throwing the rooster tail off the number 4 corner. And Scotty Parker picking it right up where he left off. And here's Eklund holding Mertens for second and third. Transferring two national half-mile winners to that main event. Here's the time at 3:39.41. Set to go now, number 18, Terry Povey, setting a new one-lap time trial record here last night in GT racing. Povey and Pearson both in the main event here, the 17 rider final for 25 laps. So was number 73, Sal Hoffman, in the back of the field. Set to go now, Randy Green, one of the top-rated rookies, number 24, 2 years ago. So California, Texas, Maryland, Michigan, Indiana, Washington, all in heat race number 2. 1, 2, and 3. Scott Pearson missed a shift, you lost a bet if you took number 95 and gave the field. Pearson missing a shift. And one of the few times he didn't get to the corner first. Out they come now. It's Texas Terry Povey, a one-time national half-mile winner this year. Number 48 is Don Howard from Forest. Number 66, Mike Enderbetson. And number 95, Pearson. Pearson just losing another spot. They're wheel to wheel. It's California's second-year pro, Don Howard. Number 48, battling the Texas veteran, number 18, Terry Povey. California on the inside, Texas on the outside, and wheel to wheel. Number 92, Rod Ferris from Baltimore, Maryland, is up into the number three spot. It's Texas, California, and Maryland. 1, 2, 3 down the box shooter now. Scott Pearson, number 95, finally gets going out there. And look at young Don Howard, the second-year expert from Clovis, California. Putting it on. Push, push, push. Michigan's number 30, Tom Maitland, is running in the number five position. A coast-to-coast lineup here. We're going to take that top three. And right now, veteran Terry Povey, one of the winners on the Camel Pro Series circuit in 1984, is still bringing them around. There goes Don Howard again, and Howard's going to try him. Here's the product of Ascot Park, number 48. This is where he learned his pro racing. And he's pushing now one of the top 10 in national standings. It's California 48, Texas 18, 5 more laps to go. Number 92, Rod Ferris, a protege, a former Grand National champion, Gary Nixon, still holds the bump spot. It's going to be between number 92 from Maryland and California's number 95 for that last transfer directly into the main event. And young Don Howard now, the least experienced rider in that front four, is the Californian number 48, trying to hold second place. Here comes the Maryland veteran, Rod Ferris, and still closing with four laps to go. Oh, and there's a big mistake by Don Howard, number 48. Number 48 with that left foot getting up behind his left ear, and it cost him a shot there. The winner will go to the front row. Second place, maybe. Third and last transfer you're going to row two in that main event. The experience of Texas Terry Povey now, the Harley rider from Texas, starting to put him away here. The white flag coming out. Nine laps completed, one to go, and Michigan's Maitland is out, number 30. Checkered flag out. Povey. Former Ascot top novice and top junior, number 32 from Simi Valley, Pete Hames, is on the pole on the outside. Ted Booty, the Louisville, Kentucky national half-mile winner earlier this year, on the inside on the lone Honda. Now watch number 51. If Mike Garrison is hot tonight, he can cause trouble out there with the nationally ranked riders. And it is number 51, the product of Ascot Garrison. But there goes number 32, another Ascot rider, Pete Hames. And they're ahead of three national half-mile winners, 12, 17, and 42. And the most experienced half-mile rider out there right now is number 42, Moorhead. Four Harleys and a Honda, the front-running five at the end of one. Steve Moorhead, pictured on the front cover of your program, the third place finisher here last May. It's still Hames and Garrison. California running 1-2. The 11-year veteran from Ohio, number 42, Moorhead, still running third and in the bump spot. Ted Booty, the Michigan number one half miler, moves in back into the number four spot. California 1-2, Michigan, Ohio and Michigan 3-4. And Jimmy Felice, number 17, the flea is not flying tonight. Buried back in the back, he's going to try for a semi-spot. Here they come, it's still Pete Hames from Simi Valley and Mike Garrison from Tulare. Down the back chute on lap five, three Harleys and a Honda. And this will be a double upset now if the Ascot kids can hold them. The 2 second-year experts from Ascot, their novice, junior, and rookie expert season. Here's going to be an interesting race now for last direct transfer. The two pre-race favorites, Harley-mounted Moorhead, number 42, and Honda-mounted Booty, number 12, are going to battle it out the last halfway for third and last transfer. A double upset is in the making. The Honda is closing the Harley. Moorhead and Booty, and there goes Booty. Booty still closing. The two privateers from Michigan and Ohio for a third and last transfer and a double upset with the California kids running 1-2. Booty goes by on the inside. And Ted Booty, who first rode that Honda, back comes Moorhead. There goes Booty. And Booty first rode this machine into 10th place in the main event at San Jose last weekend. And now Ted Booty, fighting to keep that number one half-mile title alive, is in the transfer. Steve Moorhead has been booted out of the main event. Two Harleys, a Honda and a Harley now. They're down the back chute. A lap and a half to go. A lap and a half remaining. Down the back chute we go. Pete Hames from Southern California, Mike Garrison from Central California, Ted Booty from Lansing, Michigan, and one more lap to go. One more. Checkered flag is out and a near perfect run for Pete Ames. And Mike Garrison and Ted Booty. These are the three transfers. We're going to transfer another national half-mile winner. Number 12 is going into that main event. We now have five national half-mile winners in there. But the win going to Harley Mounted number 32, Pete Hames. In second was number 51, Mike Garrison. And third and last transfer, number 1 year. The number one rider in the nation with 6 championship wins this year, Graham. And now number 12, Booty, the point leader in half-mile events, has qualified for the main. We're ready to go. And Graham got boxed out there. It was number 15. There goes Graham on the inside. A beautiful run by Graham. Picked off 5 riders. Back comes number 15, Garth Brown. And the red flag is coming out. The officials did not like that start. With 4 national half-mile runners in this one. And they were bottling up. 15, 44, 3, 67. All have taken the checkered flag first in Camel Pro Series national half-mile events prior to tonight. Calder Track Racing. Jorgie Jorgensen, the hot one last night. Sherbert and Graham chased him the whole 25 laps as Jorgie picked up his first win in 1984. Number number 54, Steve Munger. What you call the perfect start. So Steve Munger, the privateer out of Tulare. Simpson and Bill Nye, privateer Harley. Oh, look out, a big pileup, Oh, and Munger lost it there and took four or five riders down with him. Steve Munger, number 54, the fourth fastest qualifier, lost it there, coming through turn four, giving the other riders absolutely no place to go. Number 15, Garth Brow, is one of the riders down. The Delaware rider, number 47, is another rider down. That could have taken the entire field. With good luck riding there by some of the riders that got through from the front of that pack, as he completely lost it right in the middle of the groove in that number four corner. Number 54, Steve Munger, out of Tulare, after turning in a fine qualifying job of fourth fastest here.
Number 15.
Apparently number 15, Garth Brown, another of our former national half-mile winners and an Ascot winner, is not going to be coming out this time. Brown was running very well at the flag, so apparently we're going to be scratching. Moving in at number 74. Will be an alternate. Number 74, Mike Sullivan, is an alternate from the Northwest up in Washington. Moving in. Number 11P is a rookie, Del Beck from Illinois. Number 16E is Larry Earhart from right here in the Los Angeles area. Moving in now and filling in the alternates in that back row. So Scratch, one of our half-mile national winners here tonight, Garth Brown, number 15. Let's move in number 6Q and give an Oregon alternate a chance. And that's going to be Ron Adams from Clackamas, Oregon. He's riding a trial. The oldest machine to qualify for the program tonight will be number 6Q, the 750 trial twin. Inside row number two, alternate number four. 62 riders went up against the clock tonight for the 48 fastest spots. The red, white, and blue of Honda is ready. The orange and black of Harley Davidson is ready. And the multicolors of the privateers are ready for heat race number four. Number 15E, Bud Carroll from Torrance, also moves in. Number 26, Mike Minning, who got a chance to move up to the front row, led to the corner. And here goes the red, white, and blue, the 1-2 Honda, Team Honda punch of number 3, Ricky Graham, and number 67, the hottest rider in the circuit now, Bubba Schubert. The battle is on. The 1-2 finishers on the San Jose Mile are off and running again. Six-time winner Ricky Graham is going to bring them through. He's pictured on page 6 with the closest he'll ever come and still not win. Bubba Schubert likes it low. Graham is trying it high. Here they come now, the red, white, and blue, scoring it off turn 4. And Alex Jorgi Jorgensen, the Harley of Jorgi Jorgensen, now last night's winner. Jorgi rode a Wood Road Track single to the win last night. Switching over to Harley Davidson tonight. Here they come out of that far turn. Graham having problems out there. 3 laps completed, 7 to go. Schubert goes by. Now Graham goes by on the inside. The hottest combination in national racing this year. Look at Schubert gobble him up. Texas on the inside, California on the outside. The Ascot product, number 3, learned it all right here. And Jorgensen is still coming up. There they go. Number 13, Washington's Mickey Fay has got the factory. Harley Davidson in the number four position. But right now, three national half-mile winners are running 1, 2, 3. Ricky Graham brings them out. The flags are crossed. We're halfway. Back goes Schobert on the inside. Schobert likes to run it lower. Graham, the best runner and gunner in the business. In this heat race right now, back comes Schobert. He's got horsepower to just eat Graham alive. Off that corner they come now. This will be six laps completed, four to go. Team Honda is on a roll. And now number 44, and Graham is dropping out. Number three, Ricky Graham is dropping out on the back straightaway. The national point leader is out of the race on the back straightaway and rolling to the pit. Here comes Schobert. Here comes Jorgensen. Here comes Fay. And Ricky Graham, the national point leader, is out. Let's pick it up now. It's the Honda Bubba Schobert, the rider, the only rider that's got a shot at Graham to win the title now. Alex Jorgensen and Mickey Fay. Factory Honda, Privateer Harley, Factory Harley running 1, 2, 3 in the transfer spots. We're down the back chute now on the ninth lap. The white flag will be coming out, and Bubba Schobert now has a golden opportunity to capture the Grand National title. They come now, and boy, with that Camel Pro Series season, they take a turn right now. And we'll be telling you why in just a few moments. So let's transfer now. A Honda of number 67. Bubba Schobert goes to the main event, the Harley Davidson of number 44, Jorgensen to the main, and the Jay Springsteen Harley, ridden tonight by number 13, Mickey Fay, goes to the main event. Here's the...
Bump it off. Something down below broke, and the clutch was just slipping because it was way too tight. And it was slipping during the whole race, and then pretty soon it just wouldn't even go forward at all.
We see you stayed up here to push your bike across. You have an opportunity, perhaps, to get back in the last chance.
Well, we're a little bit fortunate. A couple of the guys fell off, so looks like we're going to get in the semi.
Good luck, Rocky.
Thank you.
Well, thanks, Ted Otto and Ricky Graham. I know you heard it. Ricky Graham, the national point leader, will have to fight his way out of row two in the next semi. He'll have to start in the back and go for one single transfer spot in the next event following this one. We now have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 half-mile winners in the main event. Let's see now if Scott Pearson can become the eighth on the Privateer Harley number 95. Well, this time he got it back there. He went in high and Pearson. So he's 1 for 1 tonight. Woo! And there's a rider all by himself. He's down, he's up, he's okay. On turn two.
Who fell off?
Number 85, the rider that fell off out there. That was national number 85. There's Scott Pearson now, Robert Land, Randy Green. The rookie Ross Klatt is running in the number four position. A change in fourth out there, Scott Pearson. Pre-entered in your program, listing Honda as his choice, switching over to a Harley, and he's going for the single shot transfer. Robert Land, Randy Green, Mike Inderbitson, Danny Perkins, and Ross Klatt. Now second through sixth will come back in the last chance qualifier. A good race going from second on back. But after that bad start in the heat race, number 95, Scott Pearson, former half mile and TT national winner, putting it away in real good style. Was number 85Q, the young rookie Bennett on the Honda, the rider that fell off there in turn two in that first lap. Bumping and rubbing here for second place. Second year expert, number 24 from Washington, Randy Green, has passed the California rookie, Robert Land, for second. We are now seven laps completed for Scott Pearson. And that engine is starting to miss on the leader, number 95. Number 95 is starting to misfire with that big, big lead. Can he hold it? Scott Pearson has got two more laps to go yet, and that engine sounds like it's starting to go sour there on the front runner. Can he hold it? Can he hold it now? One transfer spot. Off that number two corner, a lap and a half to go by the lone transfer, Scott Pearson. He was out all last season with a leg injury. They said he'd never ride again. Here he comes. Can he hold it now for one more lap? Will it keep running? Will it keep going for number 95? Hard luck, Scott Pearson, Randy Green, Robert Land, Mike Indervitson, Danny Perkins, Ross Klatt. Here they come. Pearson still holding. So first now, Ricky Graham, and now Scott Pearson. It's a long, tough night for former national half-mile winners. The hard luck kid is going to hold it. Transfer now, number five. He's getting the helmet ready. They have not received the two-minute sign yet. Number 37, Jeff Johnson, who qualified for that San Jose final in great style last weekend. He's up there. Number 33, the Eastern rider, Dave Helb, is up there. He's out of Canton, Illinois. The pre-race favorite, there's no question about it. Number 42, Steve Moorhead, who finished third here in May, and number three, Ricky Graham, who finished second, are both going to try and fight for this last transfer in semi number two. This is how quickly it changed. Here comes number 17, the new flying flea, Jimmy Felice, another half-mile winner. He's an alternate. He wants to get in. As soon as referee Rick Hutchins, he's looking at his watch. They're working on that machine down there. And if they once move an alternate in, you are out. Let's see how many alternates they're looking for now. The Grand National title can ride right on this event, ladies and gentlemen. This could decide who will carry number one for 1985. And we'll tell you why in a few moments. Now we got trouble with the number 33 machine, the Illinois machine. We're moving in the Indiana rider, number 69. Is he going to make it? They're still working on that number three Honda that has won six national championship events along the way here in 1984. A tough way. Randy Goss, the challenger up until last week, out with a broken leg. Ricky Graham, the point leader, now going out with his first mechanical problem of the year. And this can open the door now for number 67, Bubba Schobert, who lost his national points from three races, was not allowed to race in two other events, can still perhaps get the coveted number one plate after all. If the points that Schobert lost on the AMA appeal were added back to his total tonight, he would be right behind Ricky Graham in the national point battle, even though he did not compete in two other events. And what a tough way to go. Do you lose it in the pits? And it's all over. They're moving in Jimmy Felice to replace Ricky Graham. Number 17, Jimmy Felice, a one-time national half-mile winner, goes out there to replace now 17-time national winner Ricky Graham. We will take one rider and the definite pre-race favorite, number 42, Steve Moorhead, who has more half-mile experience than all of the rest of the riders on those two rows combined. Transfers, second through sixth, they'll come back to the last chance qualifier, and guess who's out in front? Mike Minnig is running second. The Illinois rider Dave Hebb is running third, and look at Hebb go around the outside. Here's the Illinois rider, only a second time at Ascot. He went around Mike Minnig like Minnig stopped, and here he goes, the third-year expert for Illinois. Look at him go, number 33. Holy cow! Did he take that south turn the previous lap? He rode it high all the way. And here's the 11-year veteran, number 42, Steve Moorhead, with an unknown kid from Illinois pushing his rear wheel off. Up comes Kentucky's Lance Jones. Ohio, Illinois, there goes Illinois on the outside. Hebb does not know how to square off the corners here at Ascot. He's never raced here that much. Lance Jones, as a junior, a 47-time winner. Look at him come. Kentucky 23, Illinois 33. Three riders on the board, and he'll bust down there. Lance Jones tried him on the inside. He didn't make it. And there's your 11 years of half-mile experience showing up. But it's far from over now. Here's the cross flags. Five laps up and five laps down.
Come on, kid, go get 'em.
Now look at the Illinois kid. Number 33 in the lucky green and white letters, and Lance Jones. The young man from a native of Gadsden, Alabama, now riding out of Kentucky. And he is going to score an upset here tonight if he can hold it now. Woo! Lance Jones takes it in low. And right now for that one transfer, back comes Steve Moorhead, who finished third here in the national final in May. Look at Jones, still a wheel on him. And they go on lap number eight now. They're getting lower back in front. Kentucky goes back in front. Ohio gets kicked out of the main event. Ohio takes it away. This is the semi main event, ladies and gentlemen, just for the honor of lining up in row three. Here they come, two laps to go, two to go. Moorhead gets a run on him. Jones will go in low. Moorhead goes in high. Jones gets a run up there. He didn't make it. Steve Moorhead, the old pro veteran from Findlay, Ohio, knows where to go on turn two. But it's not over yet. Here comes the white flag. One more lap to go. Ohio and Kentucky. Back he goes on the inside. You do not go through turn two. You take it in the high middle. 11-year veteran Steve Moorhead, the heavy pre-race favorite, has had the wheels ridden off for 10 laps. Here they come, it's Moorhead. The rookie expert ranks right here at Ascot. the veteran half miler with over 11 years experience, number 42 Moorhead, who was in the winner's circle here in May, now will have to come all the way from row number three and put that 11 years of half mile racing experience to the full test. Number 44, Alex Jorgi Jorgensen, the pride of Ascot, and every year turns in his best races right here at Ascot like he did last night. A four-time national TT winner, they've all come here. He's won the Ascot half mile before. Number 11, Parker, a previous Ascot half mile winner. There's two of them right there. Number 95, Scott Pearson, will start way back in row three. He cannot be the first rider to turn one this time out. The best starter in the business is locked into against the wall in the last row on that starting line. So it's going to be in the back row, Kentucky number 23, Ohio 42, California 95, and a test lap coming up now. Don Howard, and there they go. Honda-mounted Ted Booty is now 20 laps away from becoming the number one half-miler in this type points for the year. So the challenge is on now, 13 Harley-Davidsons and two Hondas for 20 laps. Rolling up now, and can Bubba Schobert continue to extend the longest, most consistent streak in history? Seven straight times he's finished first or second. The big test is on now for Schobert. And Scotty Parker carrying the banner now for the Harley-Davidson team, along with his teammate from time to time now with number 13, Mickey Fay, but the pre-race favorite has to go to Parker, winning it here right there where he's sitting right now at the checkered flag last May in our first half mile on the series. Up in that front line, Ascot and Lima half mile winner Parker is ready to go. Harrington, Delaware winner number 18, Poovy is ready to go. Louisville, Kentucky winner number 12, Ted Booty. The half-mile winners in 1984, they're gathering here at the three lines right now as we go over, and we're checking over Scott Pearson's number 95 machine. There will be no alternates in a national championship event if he doesn't make it. Under the time limit being checked now by starter referee Rick Hutchins, he just gets 15th place, no points in the portion of the purse, but Pearson is ready to go. We're all set now as they go over to check over Mike Garrison, the Ascot product up against the wall in row number two. Ted Booty, the leading half-miler, is right down the middle in row number two. On the inside, the ever rough and tough, one of the top gunners in the Midwest, number 53, Tim Mertens. The veteran, Steve Eklund, will he get off to a good start? Will number 44, Jorgensen, get off to a good start? These are not early lap runners. Parker will try and lead right through the first turn. We're ready to go. Out they come now. They break to the corner. The Hondas on the inside. The three Harleys high on the outside. And here we go. The barn-burning Ascot National Championship final. And down the back chute. In they go. They're wheel to wheel in turn one. And the wide rides heavy. It's Bubba Schobert, number 67, on the Honda trying for it. But out they come. And it's number 32, Pete Haim. Oh, boy. Can they do it now? Schobert stopped the 19 in a row. Oh, a rider is down. And a rider really took a flyer there. Going into turn number two, the red flag is out. And Schobert, Poovy, Haims, Eklund, Ferris, Jorgensen. Scotty Parker, number 11, is the rider that did that spectacular tank slapper over there and is on the deck. Right under the Earl's Performance Product sign, number 11. All right, here comes good old Scotty. He's walking in a straight line, and I tell you, when you get off after a spill like that, they want you to recite the Gettysburg Address, all that good stuff. You better be able to do it. All Here's the restart. Let's get going again, gang, now for 20 full laps. We're going to move it now for the final time. We're ready to go. Row one is ready. Row two is ready. We're ready on row three for 20 laps. And here we go. Boy, that was ragged coming off of that second and third line. But they're going to go now, are they? They held them too long, and they're going to bring out the red flag. They're going to bring out the red. A ragged run off the second and third row, and this time it's Poovy, Ames, Eklund, Schobert, Jorgensen. So if I put them in, they're putting Georgie Jorgensen back there on the penalty line now. Last night's main event winner was the reason the red flag came out, according to the way they're lining up. So Jorgensen will have to start last. He gives up a spot in row number two. Georgie Jorgensen, who shoots for the rebel tonight, can he do it now from 15th place on the penalty line? It's never been done before. We're ready to go for the third time. Up they go, Bubba Schobert, the first man into the corner. Pete Hames on the outside. Pete Hames takes over the privateer Harley, the factory Honda, down the back chute. And boy, they left Scotty Parker sitting there holding his hand on that number 11 machine when they dropped that light on. Terry Poovy is running second. Pete Hames, who has never won a national championship event. But here's the racetrack he learned it all on. He came close in the Houston short track and the Houston TT. And look at it, is that Scott Pearson, number 95, who started way back in row two? Yeah, it is. Scott Pearson. Look at Pearson. He's right up to the hay bales on that number 95 machine. Pearson is on the move, and they're burying Texas Terry Poovy. Okay, Texas running in 2-4. California 1-3. Three laps completed. Can Pete Hames hold it? Can the young man from Simi Valley, who has never scared anybody, this is finishing his second year as a national championship contender out here now. He's in the groove and running. Number 11, Scotty Parker, back in the number 5 position. A long way to go. We're down the box shooting that far turn on lap 5 of this 20-lap race. Here we go. 5 laps completed. 15 more to go. Scott Pearson, number 95, goes by Schobert. And now Poovy and number 11, Parker. Parker goes to 4th place. Pete Hames, this will be the biggest upset in the Camel Pro Series dirt racing if the young kid from Simi Valley can hold it. Up they come now. Parker starting to move up. It's going to be a 5-rider run to the checkered flag. Last week we brought 8 riders out. Schobert goes back on the inside to Honda. Schobert, 4 Harleys and a lone Honda now, and they're wheel to wheel for 2nd place. Seven laps completed. Coming off that number 2 corner now, we took 5 riders to the checkered flag at San Jose. 8 riders, we're going to take 5 tonight. Four Hurleys and a Honda now on the far turn on lap eight. And up they come. Scott Pearson is your brand new. No, he's pushing on Pete Hames. Schobert sets him up. Schobert on the inside. Scotty Parker on the outside. The two factory riders running 3-4. The private twos are running 1-2. It's a typical Ascot barn burner now. There goes Schobert to the inside. To the inside. The four Hurleys and a Honda here at the end of nine laps. Schobert to the inside, tries to get up in there. Here comes Scotty Parker. It's Schobert and Parker. Factory still running 3-4. Privateer running 1-2. Schobert goes on the inside. Here it is, halfway. The flags are crossed, 10 laps to go. It's Pearson, Ames, Schobert, Parker, Dooley, Moorhead, Eklund, Dooley. We passed the halfway mark. It's going to get serious now. We've lost one rider. We've got four challengers now. We're down to three Hurleys and one Honda. And we get ready to complete lap number 11. Lap 11 is in the record book. Off they come again. Schobert and Parker, two of the top five in the national points. The other two are not inside the top 10. Out of the top 10, but running a 1-2 double upset here now at the end of 12, and it's Scott Pearson. It's now or never for Schobert and Parker. They've got to pull the stops out from third and fourth. And Bubba Schobert, number 67, the Grand National title, can ride right here now in these final six laps. 13 laps completed, 7 to go. Goes to the inside. Schobert couldn't take him. Pete Hames still holding. Scotty Parker cannot get any higher than fourth. It's a must run. We're into the famous Ascot North Turn now, 14th lap. Six more laps to go for Scott Pearson. Six more for Pete Hames. Bubba Schobert, Scotty Parker, Steve Moorhead, Terry Poovey, Steve Eklund, Ted Booty, Rod Ferris, Mike Garrison, Tim Mertens, Mickey Fay, Jorgie Jorgensen, and Don Howard. Here they come, five more laps to go, the famous final five at Ascot. And five more. Schobert moves back into second place, drops Hayne to third, and they're lopping number 23, Lance Jones. Down the back chute they go. It's California first, Texas running second. Harley first, Honda second, Harley running 3-4. Out they come, four more laps to go, and Schobert is now on the move. But did he wait too long? Going into the corner now, Scott Pearson, who learned his half-mile racing here at Ascot. On the number 95 machine is up in front. The rider that's never been able to hold it. He can lead it, but never hold it. And now they're lapping Lance Jones for the second time. Jones pulls in. Two different styles of riding there. Number 95, Scott Pearson, goes in high, traditional Ascot style in turn one. Schobert going in low. This will be 18 laps completed, two more laps to go. California, Texas, and California, then Michigan. White flag coming out next time around. White flag next. On the final time around now. Down the back shooting Scott Pearson. They said he would never ride again. Just a year ago, and here he comes. The latest rider to add to the Ascot Championship, Scott Pearson from San Jose. Bubba Schobert, Pete Hames, Scotty Parker, and from way back, Steve Moorhead, Ted Booty, Steve Eklund, Rod Ferris, Mike Garrison, Tim Mertens, number 53.
No more yet.
Ladies and gentlemen, here you have it, and we add yet another new this weekend at Ascot, two more new champions on the Camel Pro Series in 1984. And here's the old record set by Ricky Graham, September 24th, 1983, at 7:25:20. A brand new record for privateer number 95, Scott Pearson, 7:20:77. 7:20:77. Unofficially, here's your rundown. First to the victory stand there, along with Bubba Schubert and number 32, Pete Hames. So we'll be going to Ted Otto in just a few moments down there. Miss Camel is there. We'll be opening the gates immediately following the interviews. And once again, on behalf of Agajanian Enterprise, Camel, to all of the fans for being with us tonight. If this is going to be your last race of the season, certainly looking forward to seeing you back here at Ascot for the early TT and half mile in 1985. Let's go to Ted Otto.
We're bad!
Scott Pearson, it's been a while since you stood up here on the center platform.
Yeah, it sure has. The last national I won was in 1982. I was the only one to win on a Honda that year and the year after on a half mile. And I'm right now riding a Harley Davidson. And I love it because me and my mechanics were working so hard. We've had a lot of failures. I just want to win. I just want to show everybody that I can come back after a severe injury like I had last year. I'm so happy to be here. I love it.
Did you know in the early going that you had it made, or did you hear footsteps?
No, you never know if you got it made or not here. I just, I qualified second fastest, screwed up my heat, went out and rode my own race in a semi. I told myself I'm going to ride my own race in the main. I stayed up high in the hay bales. It worked, and I just so happy to be here.
It's getting a little bit wet up here, but we're getting into the champagne shower up here already. Who helped you get into victory circle with your bike?
Well, I have a whole lot of people help me. The main sponsor who owns the motorcycle is Mike and Dennis Camp from Pick Manufacturing. And they come up this weekend to watch me. They've been behind me all year. And thank you very much. My mechanic, Dave Bird, has done a super job for us all year. I have a million sponsors I'd like to thank you. Super Trap, Blendsaw, Mega Cycle Cams. Let's see. Grand Prix Plastics, Makuni Carburetors, Works Performance Shocks, Shoei Helmets, especially Shoei Helmets, thank you. And I'd like to thank my wife for being behind me the whole time, and my very close personal friend John Tavis for helping me all year.
And Camel.
Of course, Camel. I can't thank you enough. So happy to be up here. It's been a long time.
Well, Scott Pearson, we're happy to be up here with you, and Miss Camel Pro is going to give you your trophy, and it's from Ed Kretz Honda Suzuki on Garvey Avenue in Monterey Park. Second place to...
Thank you, Ed Kretz.
All right, a very happy winner. You just couldn't quite catch that guy tonight.
Well, it's the same story tonight as it was last night. He was going a little bit better than I was. I'm glad to see Scott win. I was watching him a few years ago here, and he had a half-track lead and fell down. So I was glad to see him come back and win it.
Well, Bubba, you were cranking on there all the time, but it looked like you were just trying to keep him in sight. He was really hauling the mail tonight.
Well, he's just a little bit faster than I was.
Well, you're going to move on now and go up to Sacramento and see what you can do with a mile. You've been doing very well with those.
Yeah, hopefully I can score a couple of wins before the year's over. Today, if we can, I don't know if we can catch Ricky, but we might be able to scare him a little bit.
Keep him looking over his shoulder.
Yeah, I want to thank my mechanics, Skip Eakin, Dennis Jones, Gene Romero, all of the Honda crew down there, Ray Plum, they all did a heck of a job.
Well, Bubba, as usual, we were very happy to have you here at Ascot this weekend. You always put on a great show for us. We love watching your ride and your sportsmanship. Please come back.
We will, for sure.
Okay, your trophy tonight is from Helmet House Shoei, Colorado Avenue, Santa Monica. And Miss Camel Pro will see that you get your trophy. And if you folks will excuse me, I'd like to get over here and talk to another happy fellow who put himself in victory circle. Pete Hames, you've had a second. You got another third.
Yeah, it was a little tough out there. I let it for a while, and I knew they were coming. I could see them, and I could hear them, and all I did was just keep gassing it and hope that I could stay with them, but I just couldn't.
What's worse, trying to catch somebody or knowing they're coming up from behind?
Well, there's a lot of pressure on you when they're coming up from behind, but I think it's easier when you're running behind them and you're trying to catch them because they're pacing you.
This is only your second year as an expert. You had a very good junior year. Who's helping you?
I got Walter Brothers Harley-Davidson behind me, Aveco Diesel Trucks, Ralph Ketchy, Bill's Pipes, Simpson Helmets, Jack Dannenberg, Jim Kelly, Harry D. Foster Motorcycles, Bill's Pipes, and all my cheering crew up there. They're up there cheering me on, and all the great fans that are out here. I thank every one of you.
And you like California racetracks.
And this is the place to be.
Pete Hayes comes in third, and your trophy, Pete, comes tonight from Coors to You Ascot, Coors Beer and Corsero Distributing. And our congratulations to all three of these guys who are about to uncork with some more champagne.
One more person. Well, I got to thank Bill Wibbler, too, my main mechanic, who's been with me all year. He's done a great job, and he's behind me 100%.
And we hope to see all of you back tomorrow night where we'll have sprint cars here at Ascot. Thanks, Roxy.
All right, here's the national point standings now as we head into Mid-Ohio, the road race next weekend in Sacramento, 2 weeks from tonight. There's a 39-point spread now as Bubba Schobert moves into second. Ricky Graham still holds the point lead at 267. Schobert has now moved up to 228. Randy Goss stays at 225. Scotty Parker moves up to fourth with 206. Doug Chandler is fifth at 197. Ted Booty is sixth at 178. Jorgensen is seventh at 141.